There's so much hype right now, I think, especially in the Western press, about how China's the next superpower, and there's a lot of fear and a lot of tension now between the U.S. and China. Whenever I have friends that come visit, they're surprised because they had envisioned China be like Japan, like Tokyo, where everything's modern, it's high tech. And they're surprised that because Beijing is like Mad Max, basically.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
It's like, like sand pirates, riding like little buggies in the sandstorm in the middle of a desert. My name's Alex. I work at Vogue China, but I also DJ in Beijing. We do a monthly night here called Black Eyeliner at this bar Dada.
I'm Kyle Page. I'm a history teacher here in town, but I also DJ with Alex. Dada, this is... it's a bright spot for the future.
Yeah. It's definitely my favorite bar here in Beijing. For China in general, it was so closed off, in the last couple of decades, that it was only until maybe the early 90s that a lot of music was able to infiltrate and come into China. Whereas in the West, all that, the progression of music in the eras happened very organically. Like, for example, punk was the reaction against disco, or post-punk grew out of punk, and that kind of like natural organic progression, and that didn't really happen here. But because of that, I think they're much freer to experiment and to like mix things up.
We have these really established norms for the way a subculture is supposed to look, and here that was just completely without context. I think the missing piece here is technology.
How so?
Finding
a Beijing sound?
Well, I think in terms of when stuff was coming in the 80s, it was all coming in on cut cassettes.
Right.
But now...
so easy to get everything.
Now, thanks to the internet, yeah. Right. So there's been this exponential growth in terms of things that people are exposed to.
Right. Scenes are always international now.
Yeah.
So I think it's going to be harder and harder for any city to find their own specific sound.
Yeah, Beijing is just plugged into this global, don't make me say village.
A lot of expats, when they move here, really don't care about music so much. I think the local Chinese do care about the music, but they're not getting as much of that international exposure.
Beijing's always been... a proud city.
Yeah.
I think for a long time there's been a lot of expats in the community here that have come in with this kind of like great white savior sort of attitude at times. Like, we'll tell you what's good music, or this is what you need to do to fix your music. And I think one of the things that's happened in the last, over the course of these last 10 years, has been that Beijing has found its own feet as a place for Chinese people to make the music they want to make.
The fashion scene in China still has a ways to go. It is still copying a lot of trends, and it's not quite mature yet. But I do think there is starting to be sort of a Beijing kind of style developing. I couldn't really say exactly what it is yet, but I think that in the next 5-7 years, there will be something more distinct.